Number 5. Blues Brothers 2000. Oh my god, talk about a sequel that does not live up to the original. This movie I saw in the theaters and I could not believe what I was seeing. It was disgusting how all of these actors that were still alive came back to insult the memories of the ones that weren't. But really, at the end of the day, what I can take away from this movie and why it's in my collection, why I enjoy it, it's not the movie itself, it's the soundtrack. You got a honeysuckle bloomin' on a honeysuckle vine. And love is a-bloomin' there all the time. The soundtrack is really, really good.
You ain't no good.
And the final concert scene has B.B. King and Eric Clapton and a whole slew of other legends on stage playing together at the same time.
We're gonna smoke them turkeys.
You could just buy the album on iTunes and just forget the movie, but, you know, I don't know. I like to watch the movie sometimes because it is like watching a music video that's really, really awful and insulting to the dead. Number 4. Virtuosity. I don't think anybody remembers this one. This is probably my favorite Russell Crowe performance ever.
I'm just gonna do a little performance piece with your partner.
And I'm Javert!
Because he's a computer simulation of a serial killer. And he is like if you took the Joker and the T-1000 and you put them together, this is what you would get. And he is so friggin' fun to watch.
I'll slice, I'll dice, I'll Julianne. What about hanging? By the testicles.
And the movie is surprisingly violent. It's surprisingly gory and very R-rated, despite having such a goofy premise.
Say thank you.
I don't think this movie ever became universally hated. I just think it flew under everyone's radar because it looked so stupid.
Where's my audience? Where's my audience?
Yeah, I remember seeing this in the theater when it came out and liking it just because I was getting such a kick out of Russell Crowe's insane performance.
I'm back in the fucking box!
Number 3. Battlefield Earth. Yes, I like this movie. Oh god, Travolta, what are you doing to me, man?
I was being trained to conquer galaxies!
Everything about this movie is so bad. And I think the reason I like it is not just because Travolta is so hammy. I think of this as like a really big budget fan film on YouTube. It's so incompetently made. And yet, I love it because it is so funny to think that this could have been the start of a franchise. The ending is clearly set up to try and have sequels, and I wish that that had happened so that John Travolta would come back as a one-armed turtle in the next one, but we will never get that, unfortunately.
That's it? Yes.
And I think that's a shame because Battlefield Earth is delightfully awful.
I'll be damned.
Number 2. I had to put a Star Trek movie on this list, and to be honest, my favorite of the movies is Star Trek 3. Yeah, it's an odd-numbered one. Nobody really hates Star Trek 3. I think people think it's a good movie, they just don't enjoy watching it. Star Trek 5, on the other hand, is a bad movie, but what's so great about it is that it is a window into William Shatner's brain, and that is a view worth having.
Is it there or is it?
He makes himself, Spock, and McCoy the three main heroes.
I'm afraid of nothing.
Everyone else gets brainwashed. Uhura has to dance naked. Yeah. Scotty gets a concussion. And Chekhov and Sulu get really, really stupid.
They're lost.
All right, we're lost.
And as if that's not bad enough, he throws in a three-breasted cat lady that wrestles with him.
Damn you, sir.
And then he goes to challenge God himself.
Excuse me?
That is just priceless when you know that Shatner wrote and directed this movie.
What does God need with a starship?
It is bad, but it's not like the motion picture, which is just flat out boring and dull. This one is riotously funny. I think it's great.
Nobody's perfect.
Number one. Please forgive me. Batman and Robin.
Oh!
Let me flash back to 1997. I had seen Batman Forever and I liked it. I was on board with this more cartoony look because Batman Returns kind of depressed the hell out of me. And then when Batman and Robin came out, I got so hyped up for it that I went to see it. And then I realized after about 5 minutes what I was looking at. Batman! And you know what? I kind of got on board with that the first viewing.
I find that unlikely.
I liked it in a kind of Fifth Element kind of way. Once I started thinking of the Fifth Element as a sci-fi comedy and not a sci-fi movie, I actually started really liking it. And then I thought of Batman and Robin as a comic book comedy.
Hi! Who is this nutball?
And it wasn't until after the movie had been out for a while that I suddenly realized, oh, this is a complete piece of shit. But I never really hated it. I just kind of always laughed at it. But now that I've seen the movie as an adult, I can say that there's one thing that Joel Schumacher did do really, really well, which is the relationship between Bruce Wayne and the dying Alfred. I think that whole subplot is actually really, really well done. It's very, very heartfelt. It's very touching.
I love you, old man.
And I love you.
It's unfortunate that that's the one good thing about this movie, and it's buried under a ton of bad puns and shit. But there's one reason I kinda do like Batman and Robin still to this day, is because I do see it as the Adam West TV show adapted into a movie. And you know what? I'm okay with that. Especially now that we've had the new Christopher Nolan trilogy. I think we can get over that one.
Yes!
So that's my top 10 list of guilty pleasure movies. Movies that are truly awful, but I liked them anyway.
Say thank you.